Hello everyone, I'm Jesus and welcome to the next episode of The Road to Old School MTG. I have two packages to continue my scrying's journey. So let me, actually might as well let me open up the scrying's website and then as I usually do, I'll open up the listings of the cards I have here just to compare what I ordered and compared to what I actually received. TCG Player is where I got these from, as you can tell. So let me start sharing the screen here. And I'm also gonna share the progression of this current deck that I'm doing. So this is the Scrying's website. You can see it over here. And it has, basically it's Swedish old school. So base set plus the four horsemen. But in addition, it has some of these more modern cards that is allowed. So for my deck, I'm making a lands edge, a tax edge deck. And I actually got to play it and it was extremely slow. I won one game, I lost the first game, won the second game, but it's very slow and it's basically not fun and definitely did not like it. So this new version, I'm looking to go more aggressive, but we'll see. It's definitely, this new version is still not going to be the final one. I have my playgroup is meeting on this Saturday, so in a few days. So, and I don't anticipate me getting any more cards. I haven't made another order purchase. This is the one that I've been looking to get. So any changes other than from these will be just from my current collection. But there's the website. So I guess first let's look at the deck itself. So this is the one, the updated deck with some of the new cards I have, plus which I'll open here. So artifacts still the same, but this one is going to be so I'm going to go more all in on the Jocalops. Maybe I was thinking, debating adding a third, but since I have a decent amount of draw in terms of Latinum's Legacy, plus the land tax becomes quasi draw because I take out the basic lands out of the deck, things out of the deck, and Ancestral Rico. I did have a Brain Geyser, but I don't know, that seems a little counterintuitive having Jocalops. When every other card in the deck is, you know, doesn't cost more than three, right? Not counting the Ivory Gargoyles and the Jackalopes, right? So, plus the more lands I play, is the less lands I have for the land edge, right? So, it seems like I'm kind of want to do like a little of both, and then it ends up being not very effective at either. Meaning, you know, going quick, aggressive, low casting cost things, or big casting cost things like Ivory Gargoyle and Jocalopes. That's the main reason why this one I've barely play tested on Cockatrice. So we'll see how it goes. And also the tithe together with the land tax maybe seems like it's redundant. So I may either trim down to two land tax and then keep the two tithes, or take all tithes out maybe as a sideboard, although I don't know how that would be effective. Basically, you know, I really wanted to use tithe. It's a great card. People are saying it's basically top three, top five, maybe even the best card in the from the Scryings list. So I really that was the one that really actually motivated me to try that with Lansage. But it's, you know, like just the deck itself is kind of slow, at least the previous version. So this one, the updated, will have four Chain Lightning, which I never owned. I've been meaning to get them, but since I don't really play right in old school, there wasn't much motivation. But now, here it is. So basically, this one is going to go more with the direct damage. I took out, I believe this one took out the Swords to Plowshares, right? Because basically I want to. Direct damage will be also creature kill. So it's Sorcerer's Posture is kind of like, it's a bit of a, you don't want the opponent to draw to gain life, right? If I want to win by aggressively going after their life points directly. So, and then these cards themselves could be used as creature kill, right? So, but we'll see. And then of course, Dracolops is also a card that can, you know, if I hold off enough, I can wipe the board with this. And good thing about Dracolops, it does not remove enchantments. Destroy all artifacts, creatures, and lands. They can be regenerated, right? So bury. But it leaves the enchantments. So land tax and land's edge, or both, if I have in play, will remain, especially that land tax, right? After Dracolops, the opponent, I had it, I played that Dracolops and I kept the land tax and land's edge. I had the combo going, and then my opponent purposely was not playing any lands because he knew I was going to land tax, and basically that's 6 points of damage right there, unless, you know, they could destroy the enchantment. Yeah. So my opponent was purposely not playing lands, but I just kept on drawing. You know, eventually I already had a few lands in my hand before I Dracolops. And then I just needed to draw like two more, and then I had 10 direct damage right there, and I won the game like that. So it's definitely, I got the combo, Dracolops, land tax, land's edge. But other than that, you know, it was just slow and I didn't like it. So we'll see with the Arbiter Gargoyles. This is a pretty cool card. So I don't have any. So now I have them. This land's edge I recently got just for this deck, but I've been meaning to do it. I really like this deck in old school. Rest of the cards, I had only had two Latinum's Legacy from my personal collection from way back in the day, so I had to buy two more. Everything else, I already have bought the four types. Everything else I already had. So those are the changes. Our Gargoyles, two more Latinum's Legacy, and the Chain Lightnings. I guess maybe, why don't I play this right now? Let's see. 4, 5, 6, 7. And I'm assuming to always play second, right? So I would say 9 times out of 10, but even that's too little. But let's say just for sake of argument, 9 times out of 10, the winner of the dice roll chooses to go first, which is good for me. And if I win first, I get to choose whether I want to go first or second. I mean, if I win the dice roll, I get to choose whether I want to be first or second. And then I'll choose to be second on purpose. So it's very much in my favor that I will go second. So opponent won first, I get my draw. So nothing much. Drop the Tundra, nothing else. All right, next turn, draw. So I could Ancestral, but I could also Legacy, depending on what the opponent's doing, right? So I'll probably, because I don't want to have too many cards and then I can't play anything. So end of opponent's turn, I'll Legacy. I don't need two Gargoyles. Shuffle, untap, draw two during upkeep and draw my regular draw. All right, so I'm not getting any red, right? So I don't know if I want to drop another land. So it depends what the opponent had, right? If he had, but I do have the Arbiter Gargoyle. Like I said, I haven't played this new version too much. Since I theoretically want to Dracolops now more than before. Before, the Dracolops was not a certainty that I wanted to do. It was situational. But now with the four Arbiter Gargoyles, is now part of the game plan. So that means I got to invest in dropping lands. All right, so I dropped that. Well, let's say I didn't. I tithe first. Tithe is great because I can get the dual lands out. So, and then because the, all right, then that, boom. And now I'll play, I guess, another dual land, better than playing the island. All right. Wait, let me double check. Tithe. Yeah, you put in your hand right there and then. Right, so 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so I got 8 cards in hand. So let's assume there's something that I could disenchant. Actually, legacy is perfect. I'll do it right now. Depends what the opponent has, right? But I guess I could just drop a land, shuffle. So far, without red, let's say the opponent was being has some creatures, which is very possible. I would not be in a good position since I did not have my swords anymore. So I may have to still put the swords back. We'll see. So during opponent's turn, I'll draw my two during the upkeep. Untap, draw. All right, so I got some red going there, but still not enough. No direct damage. So, well, let's say I blast. Three, four, five, six. I have seven already. So, and I dropped the land. Did I? Play girls plus mountain. Yeah, the mountain is what I just played. So let's say I tithe, right? So I could have done that, but that does draws me. Tithe is an instant though. I could do it through my opponent's turn. So last time I tithe for a plains. Okay, tithe is not like land tax. I have to get some kind of a plains tax. That's why I get tundras, because land tax gives me basic lands. Three, seven. So s six, seven, eight. So yeah, during opponent's turn, I'll tithe your library, one more tundra in the deck, and then I'll just a basic plains. I don't have the red white dual land, or else it probably would have gone in. All right. So honestly, this game is not good. Concede. So this, now that I'm going direct damage, is of course very beneficial to do Wheel of Fortune and Time Twister, right? I don't, which I have neither of, but I could just proxy my playgroup wouldn't mind, especially considering if I intend to purchase it, which I definitely could intend to if I like this deck enough. Especially the wheel, that one's the cheapest by far of the two. So yeah, I'm not liking it. Let's see. But like I said, I'm still going to do this deck no matter what, this type of deck. Land's Edge type. All right, so opponent one first, I draw. So land, drop a Zurian Orb just to thin on my hand. Pass, opponent drops a land. I tithe at the end of turn for two tundras. Untap, draw. Depends what the opponent has. If I feel that playing like a weenie type deck, I would play Undiscovered Paradise. So let's drop a regular land. Or depends what I do want to get red for. Well, this is a good spot here. So two. Let's say the opponent cast something bolted and the turn tithe again. So I only have two tithes right now in the deck. I have four total in my collection. So now I can get out the other two tundras. My mouse is acting up. I just changed the battery. So untap, draw. So I got four tundras, but I don't know if I want to drop another. Okay, I guess I'll do another tundra. Let's see. Well, I mean the first tundra. I pass. Depends on what the opponent does. I might side blast if they have like a Sarangel out. If not, I'm gonna assume I'm just gonna let them out. So I put the tundras back. So that also seems a bit counterintuitive, right? I'm drawing for cards, which I'm gonna end up putting back anyway. So that negates the benefit that I had from the tithes to begin with. But I have two in the whole deck. I basically anticipate getting zero most games, one out of the two if I'm lucky, right? So this is unusual. All right, so I'll just, did I put two? Oh, I put, okay. Why is my mouse acting? Yes, yeah, acting up way. Moves top card layer to their library. Let's see. Oops. By the way, player puts the top card of their library on top of their library on top of their li what? Okay. Well, sorry, my mouse is acting up. I'm not sure why. Concede, but honestly, that's enough where I can tell this is not gonna work. We'll see what I do to change it. Honestly, I'm out of the two. I was gonna say I envision myself more going the direct damage and then doing some kind of a weenie deck. So doing some kind of a weenie deck and going direct damage. Weenie's doing direct damage attack quicker. That way I go full in on just me having two lands, three lands tops, depending if I get it, especially if I get an Undiscovered Paradise or a Mox, and then I just keep the rest of the lands in hand, waiting for your land's edge. I kind of was looking into Mind Bomb as well. We'll see. All right, so let's drop this. All right, so let's go into the cards themselves. Receipt, plain envelope, but the it has a top loader plus a little plastic covering, and this was taped to the receipt. That's why it was hard to take out. So two Jockalops, although I don't anticipate having maybe three max, right? But OCD, I might as well. Plus I play Alice, right? So this comes has many uses for me in particular. So this finishes off the other two Jackalopes that I had from before, from the previous video. Let me share my order list. So right here, two Jackalopes. Lightly played, five and change for each one. Lightly played. Yeah, lightly played. Yeah. Honestly, yeah. Pretty good condition. This one, yeah, I can see a bit more things to it. But just a quick glance, this one looks really nice. I mean, it is nice. This one especially could go in the near mint, can be looked at as near mint. So I'm very happy with these two. Good condition. I'd say it's light plate is generous. So now the other package, this one is definitely a bit more, has more cards. I guess let's review it. Okay, so and I only have two. I have nothing else coming in the mail. So here's the four chain lightnings between these two. All lightly played between eight and basically the $9 range. Near mint ivory cargoes because they were extremely cheap, less than a buck each. Two more Latinems, lightly played. Spectre Brothers, I just had the idea of maybe doing some kind of a green weenie type of deck. And then I had already searched it, and I'm like, okay, might as well just keep it. And two Winds of Change. I only got two, first of all, since the cockatrice deck here was already pretty super tight on cards. I thought, if I put any wins, I might just end up putting just two anyway. Plus, I don't know how effective, if I even want to use them for this current Scryings deck. Plus, it's really expensive. Near mint, $12 basically per card, right? So it's pretty expensive for a card I may probably won't even use. So, but if I like the potential, I will in a future order. Might as well order the other two, right? Just to finish it off. So basically, Chain Lightnings and Latinum's Legacy are lightly played. Everything else should be near mint. 4, 8, 10, 16 cards in total. Well, let's see. Yep, 16 card total. Just under 70. So 16 cards total. Let's see. So this is a bubble mailer. This one didn't. Well, I guess it's since I was gonna say this didn't. This one was a cheaper order by much, and it had a way better protection. But I guess this one has a bubble mailer, I guess. I personally don't think that's better than a top loader. Okay. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, the correct amount. Four near mint ivory gargoyles. This is it's funny. These are supposed to be lightly played. This looks more. This is near mint, supposedly. I mean, I guess it is, but as it was either taken out of the pack or whatever, or stored, this particular one has tunics. Other than that, made a little bit of a lip there. But yeah, other than that, it is near mint. Slight warp. Yeah, actually, it may not so slight. Oh, yeah. There's a part that's lifted up. I mean, these cards are cheap anyway, so it's more about, just the annoyance of not being accurate. Also, a little bit of a chip right there. This one is okay, I guess. Yeah, these are flat. All four of them are slightly bent. All right, well, they're cheap enough. So, Spectral Bears. I always love this card. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just to see. Should be near mint. Yeah, this looks near mint. Nice. Little bit there. Maybe one light play, three near mints, but close enough and they're cheap anyway. All right, Winds of Change. What is this supposed to be? Near mint. Okay. And they're $12, so they better be. Yeah, near mint. Yep, this is near mint. Nice. Very crisp. All players shuffle their hands into their libraries and then draw the same number of cards they originally held. So this card definitely gets played in the Land's Edge deck. So first of all, it's good just card draw to get the combo. Basically, that's what it gets used for, the combo. The main reason it gets used is to get the combo going quick. But then after the combo's placed, it can still be useful, right? Because not every card in your hand is a land. And this can trade those other kinds. So basically, it's good to like hold off and hold things that, and don't just play everything that you have. Because if you know you're going to Winds of Change or you have the potential to do that, you want to keep cards in your hand. Oof. Both are a little bit, for the latinums, both have a little bit of a bend. Latinums is lightly played. The condition looks near mint, but it's warped. It's light warped, so that's the reason why. Here we go, nice. Chain lightnings. $9 each, lightly played from Legends. This looks great. This one's slightly played. Yeah, and it has slightly slight. This one, I guess, also slightly. So, yeah, two lightly placed and two kind of hovering on near mint. So I'm pretty happy with this. And I've been really, it's a cool card. I've been wanting to get it, but like I said, I can't couldn't justify it because I was gonna use it. But I've been meaning to do a Land's Edge deck, or at least, you know, wanted. I've been inspired to do one from before. I played against it a few times. I tend to do really bad against this, so that's why I have a bit of an interest in it, because I really like combo type decks. So, happy with this one. So the expensive ones were definitely fine, and actually they're all fine. This whole lot here, Dracalypse as well. So pretty happy with this. So let's see what I end up doing with this. Definitely doing direct damage. We'll see if these kind of card draws. So the other Gyarados were cheap enough, but the Dracalopes were not, right? So they were like $6 each. So 20 something dollars I spent, and I may not even use them. But like I said, I play Alice, so I very much could end up doing something with these in that. So plus very iconic Alice card. So, and you know, $5 and change each. So I guess, you know, it's not as much as, you know, half the price of the ones of change or the chain lightnings, right? So whether I use it or not, it's still, and it could actually could still be useful as a cyber card, even if I do intend to do, you know, win by going out quickly. You know, that's your game plan, right? But the game plan doesn't always work out, especially if I know I'm playing against control, very likely the game will be stalled out. So it's nice to have some kind of a reset card, right? Especially if I get my opponent down low enough, they'll have to counter the direct damage and then hopefully use their counter spells on that and leaves me open for a Dracalopse. So definitely this is a fine card to get no matter what, and the Avery Gargoyles were cheap enough. All right, so now just a bit of play testing on my side, see what I can come up with. I'll end this video right here. Thank you for watching.